Today we're gonna focus on creating a brand new PowerPoint instead of remediating one that is inaccessible. Sometimes it could be a bit more challenging to fix a PowerPoint than to just simply start from scratch and import all of our content. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's dive right in. Today I have a PowerPoint that does not use a very good template, and honestly, I'm finding that I'm spending a lot of time trying to remediate it. Let's go ahead and open up a brand new blank presentation. And then I'm going to adjust my windows so that we can see all of the content. And all I'm going to do is start building a more accessible template. The first thing that I want to do is choose a design, and I'm going to pick one from my built-in themes. And I'm going to choose this one, and there's different color schemes we can pick. And let's give it a title. And this will be our new title. Next, let's start adding in our slides. I'm going to select the new slide option. And instead of this being, this actually works. I'm just gonna have this title and content slide. I could pick other different layouts. And we're gonna simply just type in laser room. And then let's see about adding a smart art graphic. In this particular case, we have quite a bit of content here that we need to move into this new one. All right, so here's what we're gonna do. Let's try that again. We're gonna insert a smart graphic. We're gonna select a list, and then we're gonna try to select this one, and let's see what we can get going. I think we're gonna put the first five on one slide, and I'm gonna give this a unique slide title, and let's begin. I can simply copy and paste all of my content, and we're simply going to keep that going. And then let's go ahead and duplicate this slide, and we're gonna change this to laser room 2, and then we're gonna put number 6 through 10 over in this side. And what we're doing right now is really just creating a more accessible template to begin with, and this makes the whole process much easier to fix. All right, we have another new slide. This one is called 5 Laser Safety Measures. Can't seem to type the word safety correctly. And in this one, we have another smart chart, but this is a different style of list. This one is actually pretty good. I'm just gonna copy it from the old presentation and paste it in because it is already using an appropriate list structure. So I don't have to really do a whole lot there. All right, let's keep going. And next we're just gonna go through and basically copy and paste the content in and make it accessible as we go. This is an example that we need to make a numbered list, and let's make it all the same size color. And then we can delete out these extra numbers, and we're off to the next one. And I'm again just copy and pasting to get all of our content in here. Then we're making this a numbered list. Fix the font size. Actually, these are two different fonts. In this case, it's not quite fitting, so let's change the layouts to 2 content. And then I'm gonna take numbers 5 through 8 and paste the other side. And then we can change the numbering to start at 5. Let's try that again. Sometimes it's a little tricky to get these settings. All right, there we go. So we're forcing the second list item to begin on a number 5 because that is more accessible. Now this slide looks a lot better. And let's keep going, new slide. We've got quite a few more to go. We're gonna change this slide back to a title and content slide. Make this a bulleted list. Something's up with this slide. Let's try to paste this plain text instead and then apply, okay. Since the bulleted list is having trouble, let's do it for now. All right, there we go. So it's slowly coming along. I put in a lot of effort in creating these videos, and I would love it if you can go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button for me. It really helps me out. Thank you so much. Now back to the video. All right, so I finished copying over all the content, and when I go to run the accessibility checker, I have no accessibility errors. So our presentation looks a lot more professional, and it's accessible because we used a built-in template for all of our content. Now, if I go back and look at the original and I run the accessibility checker, we have many, many more issues. We have issues with the reading order and issues with auto-generated descriptions. But more than that, I feel like the other presentation is more consistent and easier to sort of digest the content. Thank you for joining me today as we made a PowerPoint accessible as opposed to remediating a PowerPoint. If you need help with remediation of any of your files, check out the link in my description to see how I can help you get accessible. And I can't wait to see you in my next video. Thank you.